Why does Edge have so many processes? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a representative question. I looked at Edge in Task Manager, and it's got like a dozen processes running, and I'm just displaying a single page. Why? So let me show you exactly what this question is asking about. Here I've got Edge showing a single page, mine, in Windows 11. If we fire up Task Manager and go to the Processes page, you'll see that it is listing Microsoft Edge here. There's this interesting number next to it called 30. So we have exactly two applications running, Edge and Task Manager itself. However, Edge, if we now expand this, has a whole bunch of other processes running with it. More correctly, this single program we're running, Edge, is comprised of several different processes. Now, I can't really speculate as to why or what each specific process is doing. However, I can tell you this. One of the challenges in software engineering, whenever you're writing a piece of software, is how to divvy up the work in a way that is most efficient, that balances the amount of software you have to write, how quickly it's all going to happen, how the user is going to be able to interact with that software, how the software is going to interact with the system around it. One of the ways that has evolved over time is something called multi-threaded software. Ultimately, all that really means is that the software is divided up into several pieces that logically can all run at the same time. They coordinate with one another as needed to make sure that what they're doing is something coherent and, as we see here, appears as a single process, but it is a very efficient way of potentially doing things while other threads, as they're called, are waiting for other things to happen. A thread, for example, might be waiting for data to be downloaded from the internet while another thread is actually displaying something on the screen, or interacting with the GPU, the graphics processing unit, to optimize something that's going on the screen. So ultimately, this multi-threaded nature of software is simply a way to divvy up the work. And the way that a lot of these browsers are now doing that is by having multiple sub-processes. And that's what you're seeing here. Now, this doesn't mean that all of these processes are actually doing anything. In fact, like I said, since we're actually not interacting with the browser right now, most of them are just waiting. They're waiting for something. They're waiting for something that is specific to that particular thread's job. If I now sort by CPU usage, you'll see that, yes, Task Manager is actually at the top of the list because it's now having to do some display updates. But Microsoft Edge is using 1.9, around 2% of the CPU, but it's only a couple of different threads within Edge that are doing that. If we do something with Edge, then chances are some of those other threads are going to get activated and actually do some work, again, depending on how the design divvies up the work across all of these different sub-processes. Now, I'm using Edge as my example here, but since Edge is now a Chromium-based browser, you'll find this exact same situation for Chrome and for other Chromium-based browsers as well. It is in no way a reflection of poor programming. It is just the opposite. This is a way to make sure that the browser is as organized and as responsive as it possibly can be in what is now a very complicated environment. Now, that's Task Manager. As it turns out, Edge will show you this information as well in a slightly different way. I'm going to close Task Manager. We'll click on the Settings and More ellipses here in the upper right. In More Tools, you'll see that there is the Browser Task Manager. So I'll launch that. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and make that window a little bit bigger since, yes, there's a lot going on here. This, once again, is showing us all the different processes that are making up this single program. These are all things that potentially could be running at the same time. You'll see that some of them, subframes, are actually associated with individual pages or pieces of what's being used on screen. Others, the search indexer, the storage service, the network service, these are threads that are providing those kind of services to the browser as a whole. And of course, there's the GPU process, because this browser is also configured to be able to use the graphics processing unit as a way, once again, to be more efficient. Whenever this happens, whenever you're running into a performance problem with your browser, it's actually kind of interesting to come here and then once again sort by CPU so you can see who is using the most CPU. Chances are it's one of those tabs that's doing something, like maybe it's displaying a video, maybe it's running an animation, maybe it's doing something very compute intensive on the screen. But the bottom line here is that the task list from within the browser will often tell you exactly what's going on. And as you can see also, it's showing you exactly how much memory is being used by each of these threads, how much network, if any, is being used by the threads. And since each thread is its own unique process in Windows, yeah, you get a process ID for each one. So, like I said, I don't know that that really clarifies the why, other than to say it is a design decision. It's a way of designing software to be as maximally efficient as is possible and provide you with the best experience overall. It's not something to worry about. It is completely normal. Like I said, it's how software is designed these days. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/182416. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.